I think it's time for us to take the training wheels off of Cardi B. Seriously.
Y'all don't know what time it is. I got the black V-neck on.
So y'all, I've been sitting and contemplating how to have this conversation because this last Instagram live of Cardi B rubbed me in the way of just like, I'm not feeling sis no more. Cardi B, sis, you are insecure. Let me just tell y'all, before y'all even get started, I don't have no black V-neck, No, I'm not a Nicki stan, I'm not a Cardi stan, I'm just out here doing what I do and speaking on things from what I see, and that's it, that's on period. Shout out to all my new subscribers, thank you for supporting the brand King of Reese, but let's get into it. So, Cardi B did this live, Instagram live, where she clapped back at Access Hollywood. Access Hollywood went with a headline to make it seem as though Cardi B had said that her child, Culture, called someone else mommy. And that was not true. They took a sound bite and they just ran with it. What blogs do to get attention, clickbait type of stuff, that's what happens. Cardi B had every right to go off on Access Hollywood. She had every right to say that because I think that was garbage. I think that was garbage. But at the same time, was it worth it? And I think that's what we need to understand. We're always saying, oh, she can do this, she can do that, yes. But when you're playing this game that Cardi B is playing, where she is signed to a big label and her job, like this is her career, she can't afford to keep doing this. And it's time for y'all to take the training wheels off of sis. I'm really tired because I'm seeing folks, when it comes to other certain artists, they have, and the certain celebrities and stuff, they have this, the bar is all the way up here. But when it's Cardi B, it's just, oh, you know, Cardi B is learning. Cardi B, she's not as intelligent. She grew up in a hood. She doesn't know these things. Cardi B is worth a couple of $1 million to the point that Forbes might have got the number wrong and she's pissed off about that. I'm not interested in hearing anybody else say that Cardi B is learning. She's not learning. She's not. Bodak Yellow came out and what? It rose to number one and what? It's been almost 2 years. She's still doing the same stuff. She's still getting on Instagram Live clapping back. For somebody who's talking about you as a boss and you making all these decisions, why don't you make a decision for somebody to take your phone and clap back at these folks without hurting your image? Because sis, you spazzing out and pretending to spit on folks on Instagram Live and saying that somebody's mother should catch AIDS, or are you hoping that? As a person that's living with HIV, I don't want anybody in their mama to tell me how I should feel about that. That whole comment was disgusting. And if you're gonna even use that, I need you to understand that nobody catches AIDS. That's the stigma, that's the ignorance that you continue to let jump out for millions of your followers, and you right here looking stupid. AIDS is the progression of HIV. You can't catch AIDS. That's not how it works. So when you use this stigmatizing language like that, and it's pissing me off, because I'm just really tired of Cardi B always saying something, then everybody come to clean it up. Sis is point blank garbage at this point. And I've continued to say, you know what, Cardi B is, you know, I'm gonna give her some time. And I understand that Cardi B is young. I understand that she came into the fame very young, and I understand that. But sis got too much money, too many resources, too much access to be out here still saying stuff. You don't need to be arguing with Access Hollywood on Instagram. Quality Control Music, whoever they is this week, is taking money out your check to give you PR and do all these folks. Use them. Use your resources to get these folks together. Because you getting on Instagram, wasting your time and energy, like sis, they is clowning you. Them folks are going to talk about you not being a good mother to the end of time. They're going to do that. And I think you are insecure about that. I think you are insecure because, Cardi B, you're always working. You're always working. And don't get me wrong, because misogyny plays a role in this, because we don't drag men for out here working and all that. We don't do men the same way. A mother can't go back. A mother can't continue to build a brand and make money off of being a bad mother. It's not the same thing. Versus someone like Future, oh my God. Future still out here doing club performances, all that. Still got brand endorsements, all that. But somebody like Cardi B, a woman, she can't walk around with this this conversation about her being a bad mother. I think sis is insecure. I think that's what your issue is. I think you are bothered a little because I don't think you spend that much time with your child. And I'm not using that as a dig. But Cardi B, you're not a traditional mother. And that does not mean you are a bad mother. You're not just you're just not a traditional. You out here working, you getting the bag. But the only thing I'm gonna stop you is that how many bags are you, how many are these bags gonna be worth it when you don't have memories, as many memories with your child? Like, and that's just what it is. My father missed out on a lot of like moments with me because he was always at work. And I didn't develop a relationship and a loving like understanding of my father until I got older. But there were some years in middle school and high school, I was not here for my dad. I thought he was the meanest thing ever, and I think all he did was pay bills. Which was true, but I didn't understand why he was doing the things that he was doing. But now I get it. But Cardi B, you talking about getting the bag, 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 and then you saying all this in this music, then we turn around, you in here doing interviews and saying, well, I need to sit down and I need to do this and that, girl. Listen, sis, just tell these folks that you ain't no traditional mom. I'm out here loving on my child and I'm out here making this money. Like, just say that you got a good support system. I believe your child is getting all the love and nourishment that they deserve. Ain't nobody taking away, but since you got to learn how to be like, girl, I don't give a damn what these folks saying to myself. I don't play with my child. You out here spazzing out. Now, and don't get me wrong, the folks who sit up here saying that you are a psycho and all the other stuff, I think that was garbage. I did not agree with that take. I don't think that's what it is. I think that you were angry. You have every right to be upset at these folks who made this headline. But is it worth anything? And that'd be my response, like, intent over impact. Like, girl, you meant probably well when you said it, but the impact of it, was it worth it? It makes us feel good to clap back. But Cardi B, you clapping back and searching your name on Twitter and clapping back at folks who saying stuff, them people know they gonna get a reaction. They know what buttons to push because you keep telling them what number to dial. You keep telling them, they know your number. The girl, they know your number because they know you gonna answer the call. There are so many trolls on social media, and sis, you're going to have to learn to be like, you know what, I ain't got time. Take a break. Let me tell you, baby, there are so many threads and stuff about me, so much stuff and accusations and all the type of stuff. I don't have time to be out here searching and pinpointing everything said about me, how my hair looking this week, how my skin is, and did my boyfriend smack me and all that other stuff. I don't have time because I don't have that much time on this earth to be worried about people who are not here for me. I don't have time for that, girl. Let these folks get their energy out. Let them use their energy to be talking about me and have a conversation about me. But I know the truth. I'm not pressed about that. And you're going to have to learn this, sis. But I think in true form, you are insecure about your motherhood, sis. I think that's what is going on. And I just think you need to frame it as you are not a traditional mother. Like, it's nothing wrong. Like, a man is not going to be out here dealing with the same issues that you are dealing with. And you out here spazzing out and spitting on folks on Instagram Live. And where is Offset at? It's his child too, ain't it? But what you're not going to do, I don't give a damn how mad you are. You're not going to get on Instagram and sit and compare your anger to say that you hope somebody's mother catch AIDS. As if people are not living with HIV and AIDS. Are you out your mind? Are you out of your mind? B.O.B. calling you Bob? Are you out your mind? Like, sis, get your stuff together. It's not making no sense. You searching your name on social media every 5 minutes. You always responding. You say you're going to take a break. Then you're back on Instagram Live. You're back on Twitter. You're hollering. And you right here paying people to do the job that you want to continuously fight that's not a winning battle. You not winning no battles because them folks are still going to be saying everything about you. Now that they know that's one of the things that bothers you, it's going to be other videos and stuff made about you. Everybody, now these folks, these trolls know, they're going to be paying attention to you. And the moment something that comes up and they think that you ain't a good quote-unquote mother, they're going to talk about it. I'm telling you. You know you got some bloggers out here watching you. You know you got some folks on YouTube out here watching you. And now that they know that that stuff gonna get you riled up, they gonna make videos about it. And people gonna be searching it. And they gonna get views. This is how the game works. And then you always responding to that. Something that you could have just ignored. You could have just simply ignored it. And that's the best thing. Now people are saying, Beyonce would never. Girl, Beyonce, let me tell you something. Ding dong. Beyonce was trash as hell when she was in Destiny's Child, okay? That's probably why we'll never get a biography that was authorized, an authorized biography, because there was a lot of stuff that Beyonce did that was garbage. How she treated some of them folks was garbage. But Beyonce knows that, and she has had time to learn that, girl, I ain't doing no interviews, girl, because that ain't my lane. I ain't doing it. I'm not doing interviews, and I know who I can and cannot do interviews with. What you should have did is you should have called your PR person and told Access Hollywood to take that mess down. I guarantee you Access Hollywood have turned it. I guarantee you Access Hollywood would have took that down. You have to use your power and your influence in a better way than getting on social media and hollering and spitting on the camera lens. It's just not worth it, girl. And now, like I said, people are seeing that that's your trigger, and they're going to use that against you. So you've made an issue bigger, because I didn't know nothing about the Access Hollywood. There are people ain't watching Access Hollywood like that. They ain't checking out for that stuff. That's for folks who at the nail shop for 20, 30 minutes waiting on to get their nails done. Girl, that's why they had to use their clickbait title to get attention, because when you are real reputable media, what's name? You don't have to do clickbait titles like that to get no attention. When you are that girl, you don't have to act like you that girl. So you gave them the attention, because now everybody going on Access Hollywood and seeing what's going on. I didn't know nothing about that. I'm always on social media Monday through Friday, more than likely. But since you clapping back, it's garbage. And Cardi, I think that you might need to learn how to take a break at this point. There are some people out here who are willing to work for you. Some folks who are very knowledgeable on some of the stuff, but Cardi, I don't think that you, even with the access and resources and the coin that you have, I don't think you really care, because not too long ago you was out here calling somebody fat and ugly or something on Twitter. Now you got this, now you're doing the AIDS stuff, now you're talking about spitting on folks. Like, girl, you just, it ain't working for you, sis. And I'm not no doctor, I'm not no psychologist or nothing, but I'm gonna tell you, as a person who has experienced negative comments and things like this to a certain extent, girl, you clapping back ain't gonna do nothing. It's gonna wear you thin, because you are addicted to the negative attention, the small, insignificant amount of negative attention that you get. Now, to this claim that Cardi B, is held to a high standard, no, she's not. Cardi B has a bigger following, so therefore it looks as though she has more people who dislike her versus someone who has 5 million people. Like, if I have 5 million people following me, probably 10% of them folks are probably not gonna like me, following me for mess, da da da. But if I have 15 million, that means that 10% of them are higher. But it looks like it's more people, but it's the same percentage. It looks like it's more people, but it's the same percentage. Cardi B is out here known. She got a lot of fans. She got a lot of people. So people are going to be on her. But it must not be bothering her too bad, because she keep clapping back and saying stupid stuff. Then when she called out on it, she doubles down and say, wait, what was the thing? Somebody said something about the AIDS thing. And then she compared it to somebody, mother getting hit by a car. Sis is garbage. She's garbage at this point. And I don't have any more for her. I don't have any more, like, what's names for her. Like, Cardi B, I'm not interested in her apologies. I'm not interested in her. I'm learning and all that. Now that I go back and I see all the things you said in the past, from your transphobic stuff, from the color of stuff, to the calling black women roaches, all this other stuff, it makes me think, did you just stop saying it? Or is it that you truly learned? Because judging by your response to the stuff, you just like, where y'all trying to counsel me? You're not concerned about it. Can't nobody counsel you. You gonna counsel your damn self what's gonna happen. You gonna, and not even counsel yourself as far as your career run, you gonna counsel this. That's what you gonna counsel. Cause since I'm looking at you right now, I can tell you going through it. That Instagram live you did, that gave me a peek into your soul and how you feel. Because Cardi, Offset ain't no Instagram lives, ain't doing nothing. He ain't on Instagram live talking about he mad about that stuff. Since you don't sit your ass down somewhere and let your PR team, the folks that you paying to do this job, cause since you hollering and spinning the camera ain't doing nothing for you but making the situation worse. That's all it's doing. You making the situation worse for you and your brand. Because at the end of the day, you are a human being and you can only take so much. Cardi B, log off. Log off. That's all you got to do. Log off. You don't have to be on social media like that no more. But you are addicted. That's your addiction, sis. You want to know why people don't like you. Because you raised to the fame so quick you don't understand what the issues. You've not had time to deal with people closing the door and not being interested. You've not had to work as hard. Not saying that you didn't work, but you've not had to work as hard as other folks who just like, girl, listen, let me give you an example. There are some people who, like myself, who hear no frequently, but we hear no so often that it does not bother us so much. Like, we're just gonna find another way to get there. We're just gonna find another way. Like, okay, girl, that happens normally. That don't mean nothing. I'm gonna work hard. I'm gonna go around it. But if a situation for somebody like you has raised like fame so quick, you can't really take no. You can't really, like, no is really kind of like, huh, what's going on? What you mean folks don't like me? Like, you ain't dealing with it, sis. You have not had time. So, which means you need to take priority on your mental health. And you going off on Instagram Live ain't gonna help your mental health, sis, because now you've created a bigger conversation about your mental health. See how that works? But I don't know much. I just know that Cardi's in distress and she needs to find some help because this ain't looking cute. I'll say this again, and I keep hitting it back. Cardi B is allowed to clap back and she's allowed to go off on folks, but what she cannot use is ableist and stigmatizing language to clap back at folks. Nobody should be doing that, even me. Even me, I'm not gonna be out here making fun of somebody for being fat. I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna be making fun of somebody living with HIV. I'm not gonna be out here making fun of somebody with cancer. I'm just not doing that. It's a way to clap back without doing that. But girl, you need to learn how that works, or just put your phone down and let somebody else do it for you. But sis, I think you addicted, and that's all I got to say. Y'all tell me how y'all feel about Cardi B and her recent Instagram Live. I will say this, by the time I cut and edit this and drop it on YouTube, she'll probably have another Instagram Live going off, because that's just who she is.
That shit got me so